My Milanese friends are proud of their city, and they have every reason to. Milan is one of the greatest cities in Europe, with its intricate Duomo and an even more elaborate history. My other Italian friends, however, describe it as a little bit un-Italian. I couldn't understand what that meant prior to our trip. Upon arrival in Milan, however, we sensed it right away. Milan was our 8th destination in Italy, and it seemed inherently different from other cities we set foot in. We couldn't put a finger on it at the time, it just felt different. But different is not a bad thing. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Josh. In this video, allow us to share some tips in case you plan on visiting Milan, especially if it's your first time. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. Milan is considered Italy's second city, but in various points of history, it was the capital of the Western Roman Empire, the Duchy of Milan, and the Kingdom of Lombardy-Venetia. It has also been devastated several times, in year 452 when Attila the Hun invaded, in year 539 when the Goths recaptured the city, and during World War II when it was a target of many Allied bombings. The city was rebuilt and got back on its feet in the decades that followed. Today, while Rome remains the capital of modern-day Italy, Milan serves as the nation's financial, commercial, and industrial center. And oh, it's also one of the world's fashion capitals. Perhaps this is why Milan feels divergent. It's easy to imagine the whole of Italy the way it is portrayed in Hollywood films. Romantic, rustic, laid back. It's where you could see yourself living la dolce vita. But that's not always the case. While the other Italian cities put their old towns, frayed buildings, and bygone-era treasures front and center, Milan generally feels very contemporary. Sure, heritage sites abound in parts, but the atmosphere is relatively modern. Like most business hubs and global cities, Milan is a living, breathing, and bustling metropolis home to over 8.2 million people, including the surrounding municipalities. The official language is Italian, of course, but most signs have English translations. The official currency is the euro, and many establishments accept credit cards, but most still prefer cash. Milan is composed of 9 boroughs, each made up of several districts. As in any other major tourist destination, the closer you are to the center of the city, the higher the cost. I asked my friends living in Milan for the best areas for tourists to stay, and their recommendations include the city's historic core, which covers the Duomo di Milano and the surrounding blocks, Porta Nuova, also called the New Milan, which is a modern fashionable district with lots of dining and shopping options, and Brera, dubbed Artist's Neighborhood. Another part of the city to consider is the Central Station area, or the blocks fronting Milano Centrale, best for those whose itinerary involves visits to other destinations in Italy. All 4 districts are located near main points of interest, so accommodation rates are generally expensive. If your budget is quite limited, consider neighborhoods that may not be centrally located but are still pretty accessible, such as Chinatown, with lots of Italian and Asian restaurants and fast food, Porta Venezia, best known for the 19th century gate, a long shopping street, and diverse ethnic communities, and Città Studi, the student quarter, and is perhaps the most affordable part of the city because it caters mostly to students. Of course, there are exceptions. If you're lucky, you can find relatively inexpensive apartments even in the city center. We were able to snag the last room at New Generation Hostel Brera in an area between Brera and Porta Nuova, close to metro stations. From here, most of the stops on our itinerary were easily accessible on foot and by metro. Note that Milan collects city tax from tourists, which costs 3 to 5 euro per person per night, depending on the star rating of the hotel. It's often not included in the booking and has to be settled upon hotel check-in or check-out. Milan is primarily served by 2 airports, the Milan Malpensa Airport and the Milan Linate Airport. Malpensa, the largest airport in the region and the second busiest in Italy, is only 60 to 90 minutes away from the city center. Linate, on the other hand, is smaller, serving mostly European airlines. Located east of the city center, it can be reached after a 45-minute bus ride. However, two nearby airports may also be used to conveniently reach Milan, the Orio al Serio International Airport in Bergamo and Parma Airport. The Malpensa Airport has two passenger terminals that are far apart, so make sure you know which one your flight will be using. Aside from the taxi, you have two main public transportation modes to choose from. You can travel by train. Both terminals have a railway station. Both the Malpensa Express and Trenitalia can take you to the city center. If you prefer the bus, an Autostradale bus leaves for Milan city center every 15 to 20 minutes from 6 a.m. until around midnight. Travel time is 50 to 60 minutes and the fare is 8 euro one way, 14 euro for round trip. Unlike Malpensa, Linate Airport does not have its own train station. The best way to reach the city from here is by bus. Here are your options. Bus 73 or X73 is the cheapest but slowest option. There are public urban buses, locally called ATM, that can take you to San Babila Metro Station close to the Duomo. You can purchase a ticket on the bus. Travel time is roughly 50 minutes and the fare is 2 euro. Milan has two main railway stations, both located within the city center, and they are not too far apart, only 5 minutes by metro or 20 minutes by foot. Regardless, it'll be best to know which station is closer to your hotel. Milano Centrale, as the name suggests, is the central station. It lies northeast of the city center. It is Europe's largest railway station, and it's also the grandest of all the stations I have seen. It is the primary gateway for international tourists because most trains crossing the border use this station. Milano Porta Garibaldi, situated north of the city center, is Milan's busiest station as far as commuter traffic is concerned. Trains operating here are mostly domestic. If you're on a bigger tour around Italy, you can easily reach Milan from Florence, Venice, Rome, and other Italian cities by train. There are multiple journeys a day. There are two high-speed train companies in Italy, the state-owned Trenitalia and the privately-owned Italo. Both use dynamic pricing much like airlines. This means that fares are not fixed. They change over time. If you don't have fixed plans yet, you can book on the same day but expect to pay more for your seat. Usually, the fare is between 35 and 45 euro, but you can find fares that are as low as 14.9 euro if you book way in advance. If you're coming from other cities in Europe, the fast option is usually flying, but railway options are also available. There are day trains and overnight trains depending on where you're coming from. Milan is generally flat, so it's easy to get from point A to point B on foot. For short distances, we usually walk. We even tried it to get from Porta Nuova to the Duomo. And it's a great way to see the city and discover a local cafe or shop. For medium and long distances, you can rely on Milan's public transportation system, which is run by an agency called ATM. It operates a network of buses, trams, and metro. To help you navigate, download the ATM Milano official app, and then on the journey planner, enter your destination and it will tell you what route to take and how much to pay. Milan's public transportation system is fully integrated, which means one ticket can be used on multiple transportation options. For example, you can use the bus and the tram using the same ticket. How much to pay depends on how many zones you will be crossing. Milan's map is divided into 9 fare zones. The city center is in a zone called MI1 to MI3. But don't worry, the city center where most of the attractions are located is within the same zone. How much is the fare? The minimum fare is 2 euro. Each fare zone you cross incurs an additional 40 cents. Here are the types of ticket that you can purchase. A single ticket is valid for one metro ride, one suburban train ride, usually within the urban area only, and unlimited tram and bus rides within 90 minutes of your ticket's validation. To be clear, once you have used it to take the metro, you cannot use it again for another metro ride, but you can still take as many bus or tram rides as you like within 90 minutes of your ticket's validation. The validity period of your ticket starts as soon as you validate your ticket. Make sure you validate and keep your ticket throughout the duration of your journey. Do not lose or damage it. Spot checks are done sometimes. If you're caught without a validated ticket, you will be fined. Where to buy tickets? Single tickets are available at ticket machines at metro stations. The other tickets and passes can be purchased at authorized tobacco shops called tabaki, usually with a capital T sign, bars, and newspaper stands. Do you need a visa to visit Milan? Italy is part of the Schengen Agreement. If you're a Philippine passport holder, you will need a Schengen visa to visit Milan. If Italy is the only country you are going to visit, or if you're traveling to multiple countries but staying in Italy the longest, you will need to apply for a visa via the Italian embassy. For more information about how to get a visa from the Italian embassy, check out our step-by-step visa guide on our website, www.theportraveler.net, or follow the links in the description. When is the best time to visit Milan? The shoulder months of April, May, and September are ideal periods to visit because of the cool, pleasant temperatures, manageable crowds, and reasonable prices, at least compared to the summer months. In general, spring and fall seasons are great, but note that there is a higher chance of rain in October and November. Like in other countries in Europe, high season is from the summer months of June to August. This is when the crowds are at their thickest and prices at their highest. If you want fewer people, this isn't the best time to visit. Many of the attractions in Milan can be admired for free. The Galleria Vittorio Emanuele II, Santuario di San Bernardino alle Ossa, and Church of San Nazaro in Brolo all don't require an entrance fee. Some museums also allow free access on specific days and time. For example, although the Sforza Castle grounds are open to everyone at no cost, the museum requires an entrance fee. But if you show up at 2 p.m. on certain days, which is as of this recording is every first and third Tuesday of the month, you can enter for free. Schedules may change though. There are also a number of free guided tours in Milan. Yes, it's free, but the guides rely on tips, so if you like their service, feel free to give them an amount that you think is fair. Don't dine anywhere near touristy spots. These overpriced restaurants cater primarily to unsuspecting tourists. Walk for 10 minutes or so into the deeper alleys and you'll find cheaper places where locals eat. Tipping is not expected in Milan. It is appreciated but not mandatory. At restaurants, the tip usually takes the form of something else. It may be service charge, bread, or the like, and is already included in the bill. No need to tip more unless you really enjoy the service. You can also find a hostel that allows you to cook or heat your food. This way, you don't have to eat out for every meal. You can hit the grocery or supermarket and shop for ingredients and prepare your own. Tap and fountain water is potable. They're safe to drink, it's just a matter of taste for most people. But if you can afford it, feel free to spend when you can. Don't deprive yourself of good food and unforgettable experiences. It's also a great way to help the local economy. In our next video, we'll be sharing with you the best places to visit and best things to do in Milan. If you don't want to miss the part 2, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so you're notified when we upload new travel videos. If you need more information about traveling around Italy, you'll find comprehensive travel guides with sample itineraries on our website, www.theportraveler.net, or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, make good use of the comment section below. And if you have a Spotify account or Apple Podcasts app, follow and tune in to the Port Traveler podcast. You can also follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @theporttraveler, single L. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.